The Edmonton Oilers earned their 31st victory of the season and do so in a big way. 8-4 the final against the Detroit Red Wings. And that's why we lean on 630 Chad's Bob Stauffer to break it all down. And let's start with the very top. And I'm talking the top of the list of best players in the world. There's no debate because Connor McDavid certainly closed all of those discussions. 6 assists. He has 603 assists, Bob, in 616 NHL games.
It's only like the third time in the last 25 years that a player's had a 6-assist game. So it's happened earlier, ironically enough. This year, Chris Letang did it. Of course, Leon Draisaitl a couple years ago against Ottawa. And it had been a long time during the dead puck era where we had a guy have – it was crazy. I mean – there were some bizarre numbers going into tonight's game, Tony. The Detroit Red Wings were 28th in the league in expected goals for 5-on-5. Edmonton was first, okay?
Okay.
The expected goals for in this game at 5-on-5 were about 2.75 for Edmonton and 2.5 for Detroit. And Edmonton scored 8 goals. Like, it's like, I talked to a couple of Detroit players after. They're like, we're just glad he didn't get back on the ice for another shift in the final 2 minutes because it was going to the net, too. So, like, it was, you know what, through, like, they were just directing pucks on the goal. He, you know, Morris Seider is going to have nightmares about Morris Seider's a great young defenseman.
Excellent play.
But Connor schooled him in a couple plays. And I think back when it was a 3-3 game late in the second period, and Connor did a flyby on the net drive, and then Alex DeBrincat got engaged, and Corey Perry came in there, and I'm like, you know, I don't know if I really want to. Like, Alex DeBrincat's a hard-nosed, competitive guy.
Yes.
Of course, he's Connor's former teammate in Erie. But Connor was like a man possessed. And it's, if you're an Oilers fan, it is awesome to watch. We're watching the most advanced player that has ever played this game. Nobody's been that fast and that skilled. And he just went supersonic gin and tonic in the third period. Right?
That's so, a great one.
Right? That's what it was. And yeah. And I might have one of those after. But anyways, the bottom line was it's pretty special to be able to watch that.
Hey, you always deserve one, Bob, at the end of each and every night. The hardest working man in hockey right
about,
here.
I don't know about that.
You talk about the most advanced player. Of course, McDavid advanced his team in a big way tonight. But it was a collective effort, including goaltender Stuart Skinner. He turned aside 34 of 38 tonight.
Well, the Oilers were leaking chances. Detroit did a great job. They stretched the ice. And you look at the second period, I think the shots on goal were like 18-6 or something like that.
Yeah.
And I'm actually surprised at even – well, maybe I shouldn't be at even strength because I got the 2 power play goals. But Detroit was creating lots of looks, and the Oilers knew it was coming. They knew that the Red Wings like to stretch the ice, and they can skate. And the Oilers made a couple subtle adjustments. They split up McLeod and Holloway. Those guys were kind of – they're almost tracking the same way, and they ended up sort of in each other's space a couple times. And they split them up on different lines, and I think that added a little bit more support speed throughout the lineup, which was important because Detroit can really skate. That's a deep forward group for the Red Wings. But Stuart Skinner. I mean, Stuart Skinner, he gave up 4. Tony, he was on his game tonight. Like,
yeah,
he had to be good because they had lots of opportunities, especially through about the first 45 minutes.
He earns his 20th victory since November 24th. That leads the National Hockey League during that span. And speaking of numbers, I mean, where do you want to start? I mean, you have Bouchard, Nugent Hopkins with 3-point nights, and then you have 3 other players with multi-point nights, including Cody Ceci, who gets on the board. That's a big one.
You could see, first of all, there was no way Nugent Hopkins, even if it had marginally touched him. He was like, he was making sure CeCe got that goal right away. Like
100%.
And Ryan had been a little quiet offensively and sniped a couple, obviously, in the third. But, you know, you can tell just by the response, Connor talking to Cody after the goal. I mean, it had been 127 games since he'd scored.
Yeah.
That's not necessary. The team led the league in goals last year. After tonight, it climbed back into the top 5 in goals, 4 per game. This year, but Cody's, for 5 consecutive seasons, Tony, Cody Ceci's been basically a plus 10 player, you know, and he's done it with 3 different teams. And he's, you look, and I know people have, well, you know, you're in a salary cap, right? And I think he's earned his contract based on his performance, regardless of whether or not he scores goals or not. I mean, he's on the right side of the puck. He plays 18 to 21 minutes a night. He's on one of the 2 penalty-killing units, which until the last 3 games have been awesome.
Yeah.
So I think there are a lot of players on the team really happy for him. And I think that, you can just tell there's some guys, obviously he's very, you know, you can see a bit of a connection between him and Draisaitl at times. Nurse and Ceci, they went back to those pairings. Again, it was not a perfect night, in large part because what Detroit was able to create off the rush, which had a little bit to do with the work back to the puck with some of the owners forwards. But I think a lot of guys would have been happy for Cody tonight.
Well, it was a quick return home for the Edmonton Oilers, and it's a return into the win column. Now back on the road, so have a great road trip, Bob. I'm not on it. Paige Martin is on it.
It just got
better.
Look,
you see how excited he got?
Well, you sit behind me, and sometimes you're stretching those hamstrings. And
I'm jealous. It was one time.
And I'm jealous because I can't stretch my hamstrings anymore. So I'm going to miss you on this road trip.
Well, have some fun. Make sure you give Paige a great time out in all three cities that you guys go out to. A lot of good spots in each of the three cities. But first and foremost, enjoy that beverage tonight, my friend.
I'm going to have a 7-Up.